So we're going to go ahead and pick up where we left off with the regulation of food intake. So there's satiety factors that are involved in both short-term and long-term. If it's long-term, that's going to involve leptin. If it's short-term, it's going to involve insulin, CCK, and then some neural input from your chemo and mechanoreceptors. And then in terms of the feeding behavior, in other words, why do you eat, there's also short-term regulation and long-term regulation for those as well. Both of these involve orexigenic factors. Ghrelin, this hormone here, is also an orexigenic factor as well. All right, so we're going to be going through each one of these. So this, again, is just sort of a recap of what we're going to be discussing. So let's take a closer look at leptin. So once again, leptin is a hormone that is synthesized and secreted by the adipose tissue. So leptin then, since it's a hormone, right, it goes into the bloodstream, and then it targets the hypothalamus. So once it targets the hypothalamus then is going to synthesize and secrete two satiety factors. Those are alpha MSH. Alpha MSH is alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone. Okay, then the other one is called CART, C-A-R-T. So what this stands for is cocaine and amphetamine related transcript. And so what those are going to do then is they're going to target another part of the hypothalamus called the paraventricular nucleus. And the paraventricular nucleus is the one responsible for synthesizing and secreting corticotropin-releasing hormone, CRH, and thyrotropin-releasing hormone. Remember that once they're released, they travel through a portal vein to get to the anterior pituitary. Once they're in the anterior pituitary, it's going to synthesize and secrete its respective hormone. So remember, corticotropin-releasing hormone will cause the synthesis and secretion of ACTH from the anterior pituitary, and thyrotropin-releasing hormone will cause the synthesis and secretion of thyroid-stimulating hormone from the anterior pituitary. So these two hormones then will go off to their targets. So ACTH, as you know, will target the adrenal cortex, and that will cause the synthesis and secretion of cortisol. TSH, as we know, targets the thyroid gland. The thyroid gland will then synthesize and secrete thyroid hormone. So now we have both cortisol and thyroid hormone in the blood, and we know that cortisol and thyroid hormone both impact metabolism. So they're going to increase metabolism. So all of this is happening because of leptin. Remember that leptin is the hormone that makes you feel full. It's a satiety factor for long term. Okay, so here are some other factors then that are going to contribute to satiety. All right, and again, these are suppressing your hunger. If you feel full, you're going to suppress your hunger. So in short-term regulation, you have insulin. And so we know that the pancreas, specifically what cells of the pancreas are going to synthesize and secrete insulin? The correct answer are the beta cells. And the beta cells are going to synthesize and secrete insulin under what conditions? Remember that the pancreas or the beta cells will synthesize and secrete insulin when there's a high blood glucose level and high amino acid levels in the blood as well. Okay, so the thing about insulin, though, is that insulin is going to act on the hypothalamus. So start tying in the hypothalamus to these feelings of fullness or feelings of hunger. The hypothalamus is responsible for those. So insulin then, once it's synthesized and secreted because of those conditions, it will go up to the hypothalamus, and then the hypothalamus will trigger satiety. Okay, then there's the hormone CCK that we're going to talk a lot more about. But for now, CCK is synthesized and secreted when there's a presence of food in the duodenum. So that can lead to this feeling of being full as well. And then also you have neural input from mechanoreceptors. So think about the gut being full, it's distended, right? So mechanoreceptors are going to detect the distension, and therefore you'll feel full. And then You're also going to have the chemoreceptors that are going to detect products of digestion. And that will trigger satiety as well. So those are short-term mechanisms. Now, so those are things that suppress your hunger. But what promotes eating? So first off, let's look at the long-term factors. So this is long-term, everything on this slide. So you have these orexigenic factors. There's what's called neuropeptide Y and a GUTI-related peptide. So what these things are going to do you think that they're going to increase parasympathetic activity or sympathetic activity? Again, the goal is to promote eating. It's going to cause you to eat. So the correct answer is that these factors here are going to cause an increase in parasympathetic activity. And then do you think these factors are going to inhibit ACTH and TSH or stimulate them? They're actually going to inhibit the production of ACTH and TSH, and that way you do not produce cortisol and you don't produce thyroid hormone either. Then there's also the short-term regulation of feeding behavior. So in other words, why do you eat? Okay, what causes you to eat? And that's this hormone called ghrelin. This is a gastric hormone, so it's released by the stomach. And it's released by the stomach when the stomach is empty. And so when you think about the short-term regulation, also think about, okay, well, the food smells good. You know it's going to taste good. It looks good. It's a social activity and so on. Those things may all cause feeding behavior to occur. Okay, so that concludes this segment.